We introduced a new function called the hyperbolic arcsine and discussed some of its properties. Let's recall the hyperbolic sine of x function and its graph. And let's answer the following questions. Is this function one-to-one? The answer is yes, because it passes the horizontal line test. Does this function have an inverse? The answer is also yes, because all one-to-one functions have an inverse function. And here's what it looks like. We call this function the hyperbolic arcsine. However, it is not a new function, and we have seen this function before. So what is the equation of this function? Let's find out. Let's find the equation of the inverse of the hyperbolic sine function. To find the inverse, we first swap the x and y in the equation, and now the goal is to isolate the y variable. We multiply both sides by 2, then we multiply both sides by e raised to the power y, then we collect all the terms on the left side, and now we let u be equal to e to the power y. So we have a quadratic equation for the variable u, which we can easily solve. To solve the quadratic equation for u, we use the quadratic formula. As a result, we obtain the two solutions. However, since u is positive, we have to discard the negative solution. Now, we recall that u is e to the power y, so y is the natural logarithm of u. So we solve for y, and finally we get the following result. So we found the equation for the hyperbolic arcsine function. Both the domain and the range are all real numbers. We introduced